Hello everybody, I am going to be creating another card today. This one is a really simple, messy watercolor card with a really nice sentiment, big sentiment as a focal point. So all of the supplies will be listed down below. So if you are curious to where I get them or what I used, if I forget to say what I'm using, all of the supplies are always listed in the description box below. So I first wet the Arteza watercolor paper with some water, prepped the whole page, and then I am going in with some watercolors from Prima. I am using three different sets. I use the Classics, Odyssey, and Tropicals. They are all beautiful. Some of them have the same colors in them, a few repeated colors. But I didn't know exactly what colors I wanted to be using at this point. So I just had them all three right there. So what I do is I have some water on the side and I dip the brush, and this is a Prima watercolor brush. So I dip the brush in the water and then I dab the brush in the paint a little bit. And then I just kind of help it flow around a little bit. And then when I feel it needs a little bit more water on the edges so that it flows out really nicely and blends out nicely, I just use my sprayer to spray out a little bit. So as you could see here, the water helps the paint spread out and blend really nicely. So I go in with the blue, and then I'm going back in with the purple. And I think I used two different shades. So the first layer of color was different. I think definitely on the blue, on the purple maybe, but the pink is the same. So at this point I am happy with it. I do go in a little later and do a little bit more blending out on the edges. But that's pretty much it. So I'm taking my Tim Holtz stamp platform, and this stamp is from Neat and Tangled. And it says, "You are my most favorite," in a really cool font, and it's really big. It fills up pretty much the whole card front. So it's really nice sentiment. And I'm taking some Versamark ink, inking it up, and as usual, I will stamp it twice. Just so that I get a nice crisp image, especially because it is a sentiment. I want to make sure that it is all going to be covered with embossing powder. And I am using the super fine white embossing powder. I love this stuff. I use it all the time for almost anything that I use white embossing powder for. And that now I'm going to heat set that with the heat tool. It just melts the embossing powder, and as you could see, it just the watercolor in the background and then the nice crisp white sentiment just is really nice, I think, just for a simple card. If you're in a hurry, this is a great way to make a quick card, just a little bit of watercoloring sentiment. And then I am actually splattering on some Picket Fence Distress Spray. I wanted some white splatters in the background just to give it a little bit more of something, a little bit more texture. And then after that dries, I actually tear the bottom of the panel, and then I'm going to pop it up with some foam adhesive. Oh, first I rough up all of the other edges. I felt it was not balanced with the bottom of it being torn and then the edges not being a little roughed up as well. So now I'm popping it up with some foam adhesive or fun foam. I get these on Amazon. I think they come in 10 by 12 or something, 8 by 11 or something like that. And they're really nice to have so that I can cut them whatever size that I want them. And now I'm going to finish the card with some Neat and Tangled sequins. And this set is the Fairy Garden Sequin Mix. I have recently been purchasing sequins. I love just the extra little touch it gives projects and cards. And this tool I got on Amazon. Let me get it real quick. It is the Marvy Jewel Picker. It has two ends and they're sticky. And it just helps pick up like little sequins or beads or things like that that you want to add to your projects. So that's going to complete the card today. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I do apologize for the loud air conditioning. I live in Nevada, it's super hot, no way around it. Anyways, here's a couple of videos you might enjoy, and I will catch you guys later. Bye.